We've been looking at ways to reduce the nutrients, nitrogen and phosphorus, from waters of the West Slope for quite a while now, for both the Winnegat Firming Project mitigation and Grand Lake Clarity, because these nutrients can cause algal blooms, so they're of some concern over on the West Slope. And biochar came to our attention as a low-cost, passive, potential removal option for us. So biochar is a charcoal-like material that has a lot of surface area, and if you put it in the water and the water flows through it, these nutrients, nitrogen and phosphorus species, can be taken up and absorbed by the biochar, and so that's a removal mechanism. And again, it's low cost and passive. So we started this pilot this summer because we have a lot of questions associated with the use of biochar, including how it might be installed in these waters, in these flowing waters, how much in the way of nutrients can be absorbed. We have nutrients that are come in different characteristics, and we don't know how well they'll be taken up by the biochar. So this is a project to answer some of our questions. We don't know if we'll move forward with it into the future, but we're just starting now with our pilot study. So we've selected two sites, the North Fork of the Colorado River, and our installation site is near the Grand Lake Golf Course. And then we have a site on Church Creek, just upstream of Willow Creek. And both of these sites have different kinds of nutrients, and so we can test out the ability of the biochar to take up these various nutrients.
So to date, we've installed 4 cages on Church Creek. When we put those cages in the stream, we kind of hammer them into the bottom with some rebar stakes and fill them with about 8 socks of biochar apiece. The particular biochar that we're using for our pilot study, we actually sourced from an outfit east of Berthoud. They make a lot of their char from waste pine. We had some metal cages fabricated to hold some of these socks with the biochar that we pinned to the bottom of the creek and allows the water to flow through the char and hopefully absorb some of those nutrients. We're hoping to get into the North Fork in the coming weeks. The runoff flows are still elevated at this point in time, so we're waiting to get into that site. These cages are going to be deployed from this spring through probably late September, October. Over the course of that time, we're taking upstream and downstream water samples to see if we see any differences in concentrations in the water. And in October, when we go and pull these cages out, we're actually going to take samples of the biochar itself and send it off to a lab in California to try and analyze what exactly was absorbed to that biochar.